years of increased scrutiny over police misconduct, law enforcement has been forced to take a look at rebuilding community trust.
Edmonton police say they are trying to turn that talk into action. But with three new volunteer advisory councils, what's being done to hold them accountable?
The officer that showed up turned the event from me being the individual that needed the assistance, or as you would say, the victim, ended up becoming the suspect.
After a negative interaction with an Edmonton police officer, Zaki Harabe wanted to mend relationships, inviting the officer to a community event, only to be turned down.
When you learn others' cultures, you're better able to serve them. And so when that opportunity was missed, I felt really disappointed. Experiences can help with solutions. And so just saying things, it's not going to work.
As the co-chair of the chief's new community council, he'll be tasked with making sure EPS goes beyond just talk, along with an Indigenous and LGBTQ2S+-led council.
Is this going to cause problems in your community if we release this? Those are sounding boards that we now have. You know, it's not going to be perfect. We're going to make some mistakes, but it's going to be better than what we have.
Chief Dale McPhee acknowledges some changes to policing are out of his hands, like when it comes to the system to investigate officers for use of force. Hopeful, Alberta's work to rewrite the Police Act, currently under review, will address flaws and help build more trust. But says EPS has undertaken unconscious bias training and is piloting a program for new recruits with inner-city nonprofits.
Gone off taking their equipment and their uniform off, and they're going to work to see what it is, helping a vulnerable person.
Well, these committees existed in some form previously. They now have an ability to reach out and consult with community to hopefully create a stronger dialogue.
Bring your walls down is not a sign of weakness, because a lot of times law enforcement is seen as like just enforce the law. But it is also going to take time.
In Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.